You've been asking for this topic for a while, and I'm so glad I'm filming it today and get to share this information with you about collagen. And in this video, it's gonna be really comprehensive. We're gonna talk about what is collagen, peptides, how is it made, how do you take it, what's the difference between the different forms like powder, liquid, capsule, topical, which ones work, which ones don't, what should you do, how is it absorbed, how much should you take, how long should you take it, is it safe, what are some good brands. So really thorough, and I hope you find a lot of value. I'm Ashley Oswald. I'm a registered dietitian, founder of Oswald Digestive Clinic, where we help people improve and eliminate bothersome gut issues, so things like gas, bloat, diarrhea, constipation, acid reflux, and so much more. And today I am filming from the rainforest in Costa Rica. It's very humid, so I'm using my just video on the laptop, and you can probably get to hear the birds and maybe some rain soon. It's sunny in the morning. Usually when it's sunny in the morning, it's rainy in the afternoon, so I hope you enjoy the little slice of nature in this video. So let's go ahead and dive right in and start out by talking about what even is collagen, peptides? Like, what does that even mean? So an easy way to think about collagen is that it's basically protein. It has a certain amino acids like glycine, proline, hydroxyproline, and hydroxyproline is not in normal protein, so that's kind of unique to collagen. And it's basically that glue that kind of holds the body together. So about a quarter of our body is made up of collagen. So it's in our bones, it's in our skin, it's in our tendons and ligaments and connective tissue, the cornea of our eyes, and more. So a quarter of the proteins in the body is collagen, and it basically comes from the hide on animals, or like the skin on animals is how what we take to then produce the supplemental form of collagen. And we're going to talk later on about how you can get it from food as well and what are some of the differences. And so the collagen production in the body, it starts to decline when people enter their 30s, like age 30s, and that's why starting like the 30s or 40s, people might start to notice more wrinkles, because it's that collagen that really helps to keep skin nice and smooth and wrinkle-free. So like a baby's skin is really smooth, right? Wrinkle-free. It's because they have a really high supply of collagen. And then as we age, we start to lose collagen, and the body's just naturally. So collagen is made from mostly animal hides, like cow, pig, chicken, and fish are the most common for making the supplemental collagen. There is some that's made out of eggshells too, but there's no such thing as a vegan collagen for that reason. And how the collagen peptides are made is the hide of, say, maybe a cow is first boiled. So heat is used to help break it down into gelatin. And then enzymes are used to break down that gelatin into collagen peptides. We basically have that protein that's coming from the animal hide. And then the heat and those enzymes are breaking it down into smaller versions, which are called peptides. So then collagen peptides. And then peptides are basically little sequences of amino acids. So, say you're eating a hamburger, that protein, your stomach acid and your intestines break that protein down to amino acids in your body, and that's what gets absorbed into your body to be used. And so, these peptides are like multiple amino acids together, but those can get broken down into the single amino acids. And that's what I mentioned, like the glycine and the proline are these amino acids coming from that bigger collagen protein. So it's just a bigger sort of molecule kind of being transported. And so these peptides, the benefit of that is really two part. It's going to get absorbed into the body a bit better. And then also, gelatin versus collagen, you might say, why don't we just eat the gelatin then? There's some research saying that the absorption is about equal. So it's not that the It's not necessarily that piece of it, but gelatin, if you've ever eaten it, doesn't dissolve very well in cold. So it's not as sort of user-friendly or practical. So if we break it down to collagen peptides, you can mix it in cold, you mix it into warm, into hot, into everything. Whereas the gelatin, while you might get similar benefits, with the what we're going to talk about next, it's only going to dissolve into warmer, hotter liquids. And so how does it actually get absorbed in the body then? You eat those collagen peptides, And it goes past your stomach and to your small intestine, and you have your enzymes coming from your pancreas and then enzymes on your brush border, which is basically that inside lining of your intestines. And these enzymes help to break down those peptides even further into those amino acids. So there might be like three chains, two chains, one chain, single amino acid that then's going to get absorbed into your bloodstream that can start to have those benefits on your body that we're going to talk about. And there is some information going around online saying that we as humans absorb from certain animals like cow better than other animals like fish. And I just want to kind of bust this sort of myth, because there's actually research also showing the opposite. So certainly you can like pick and choose your research, but you have to really take a look at the big picture. And honestly, from a common sense standpoint, that doesn't even make sense, because look at the Mediterranean diet and some of these diets in the blue zones around the world where people are living really long and really healthfully, where they have a high amount of fish in their diet and they're getting collagen from the fish. And so to say that we're more genetically aligned with these other animals and that's why we can't absorb like the fish collagen is just not true. So I hope that's helpful. And we checked this hydroxyproline in the urine, which gives an accurate marker of how much collagen you took in within 6 hours after taking the collagen. And the research also shows, and there's some misinformation about this going around online, and you know, certainly because certain companies are really trying to distinguish themselves and want people to use their specific product, but just know that even the powdered collagen peptides, they are going to get about 90% absorbed within 12 hours of you taking it. Now, the reason somebody might not absorb is pretty rare, because think about it, we're breaking it down to peptides already. So it's like an easier form of protein for your body to tolerate. And if somebody's really having trouble like eating a, you know, hamburger or chicken or just, you know, beans or some sort of like whole protein, what we would do then is supplement with like a sort of peptide sort of protein in like a powder form. So if somebody can't absorb the collagen peptides in powder, I mean, that's probably a much more serious issue, pretty rare, and we'd have to start considering like vein feeding. But I digress, just trying to bust that myth that's going out around there. And so let's next talk about, what does it even help with? What can collagen peptides help with? And so the research is really around skin health and osteoarthritis. So osteoarthritis, basically inflammation of the joints, particularly knees, is what you hear people complaining about. And then skin is mostly related to wrinkles. And so the collagen can help with hydration and elasticity. It's estimated that as adults, we lose about 1% of the collagen in our body every year. And supplementation with collagen peptides could improve wrinkles by about 10 to 20%. And women tend to have lower amounts of collagen naturally. So women might notice more benefit by taking supplemental collagen or focusing on food sources rich in collagen, which we'll get to. And interestingly, it might have more benefit on skin that's had a lot of UV sunlight exposure. And that's because that UV light from the sun can actually activate enzymes that can break down the collagen in the skin quicker. And that's why you might hear, you know, make sure to wear skin blocks, you don't get wrinkles. That would be the scientific reason for it. And so I just want to add my two cents here, because in the culture of the United States, we see wrinkles as like such a bad thing, right? And people are getting Botox even in their 20s. But why do we have to perceive it that way? You know, other cultures, they really celebrate aging and how the body changes with aging. And certainly, if somebody is getting a lot of wrinkles too early on, you know, symptoms, like we could consider that information, and maybe the collagen production is getting used up too fast, maybe a lot of sun exposure, and maybe that might lead to like joint issues down the road, and that's where we would want to try to prevent some of those issues. But just for like cosmetic reasons, you know, maybe we can try to change our perspective as a society too, and just embrace this aging process as well, and try to let go of the stress that, you know, we have to look a certain way. So I just wanted to add that there, because I want this video to be very health focused and not superficial, like be Instagram perfect and take collagen sort of a thing. And there's also some research showing promise with help with healing burns, healing pressure ulcers, maybe some some cognitive improvement, but we need more research in some of those other areas. So right now it's mostly skin health, hair, and osteoarthritis. And so let's talk about how much do you need to take for how long to start to show some benefits. So for skin health, you're going to want to take it for at least a month, and it might take up to 6 months to start to notice benefit. And then for joint health and joint pain, you'll want to try it for at least 3 months, probably up until 6 months before you stop. So if you have osteoarthritis, give it at least half a year to see if you're noticing benefits. And the research does show that you just need between about 1 to 9 grams a day to get benefit. And this is some more myths that I see floating around where, you know, you need at least 7 grams or whatever. But one of the most well-researched types of collagen peptides, the research shows for that one, Verisol, that 2.5 grams a day is effective. So next, let's talk about the different types. There's mostly three main types you're going to hear about: type 1, type 2, type 3. Type 1 and type 3 are mostly helpful for skin, and then type 2 for joints. And so type 1 and type 3, the most well-researched form, or I guess brand of this, is Verisol, and I want to share the research stats with you here. And that's from pigs. It is type 1, and 2.5 grams a day was found to help with eye wrinkle reduction by 7.2% after 4 weeks and 20.1% at 8 weeks. And after it stopped, it stayed decreased by about 11.5% more than placebo. And then I want to mention the vegetarian and vegan form. So that vegetarian one I briefly mentioned from the eggshells, it really doesn't show to be super promising, to tell you the truth. There might be a modest improvement in hair and like really super modest in joint health, but if you really want to get the benefits from collagen peptides, you're going to have to and want to use the animal forms. And then vegan, there's no such thing. You can support collagen production in the body by taking vegan sources elsewhere, like vitamin C, to support your body's own production of collagen, but it's just not going to be as effective as either getting the collagen from food forms or supplemental forms. And so let's dive into the different forms, like the cream, is it worth the high price tag, and liquid versus powder, which we kind of touched on already, and capsule. And before we do that, I want to quickly share a masterclass I created, which is 5 steps to improve your gut health, where I share 5 secrets to improving your gut health, 5 factors that could be either harming or helping your gut health, and then 5 tools and things that you can do right away to help your gut health. And so the link is going to be in the comments below and then the description if you want to join us for that. So the different types of collagen are the different forms. So basically, the powdered and the capsules are really similar. It's just the capsules have a smaller amount because the powder, you're taking a whole scoop. You're going to get more of the capsules. You might just have a few grams, but that might be enough, right? I don't know why somebody would do the capsule over the powder outside of convenience for traveling, because the powder, you can hardly taste it when you mix it into things. And capsules, I mean, who likes to take capsules? Some people do, I don't. The liquid, then, there's some information online saying, you know, liquid is better, it gets better absorbed. And then the analytical brain says, yeah, that makes sense, right? It's liquid, not powder, that would be better absorbed. But it doesn't matter, you guys. If you can't absorb the powder, there's something really seriously going wrong with your gut, because that's like proteins already broken down. So the liquid is not going to be better absorbed. And then the creams, that is all marketing. Like, they might have research saying, hey, look, this cream helps improve wrinkles, and they might not be lying, but it's not the collagen in the product that's helping, it's the other ingredients in the product that's going to be helping. And so collagen, it can't get absorbed through the skin, so it's all marketing. But those products might still give you benefit, because they have things like vitamin A, vitamin C, glycolic acid, and all that helps to create collagen in the skin, and then also can just help to protect the skin in other ways. So if you really want to notice the most benefit with your skin health, then you're going to want to just take some sort of supplemental or food-based form. So that comes to the question, but are the supplements safe? So yeah, they're pretty safe. They're probably some of the safest supplements on the market. Research shows up to about 10 grams daily, used for 5 months, is safe, and it's just because we don't have research that goes beyond that. Some of the reported adverse effects include nausea or diarrhea or headaches, but it's pretty rare. But if you have a fish allergy, be super careful about buying a fish collagen product. Like, obviously avoid it. So any allergies, like avoid what you have an allergen to, which you probably already know. And then the other safety concern is for like all supplements really, and that's just contamination, adulteration concerns, which adulteration is just basically a product saying this is what's in it, but they maybe use a different ingredient as a filler, maybe to save money and whatever. And so there's some third party companies that will actually test supplements that are on the shelves and look to see if there's heavy metal contamination, what's in there is actually what the label says, and kind of price for value and things too. These companies are really great. And so with collagen supplements, one of them, it was found to have a high cadmium, which is a heavy metal, and it was likely due to the cocoa in that product because cocoa is notorious for having high cadmium. But a lot of the other products reviewed, it didn't have heavy metal contamination concerns, so that's good. And then somebody asked me about fish versus cow versus pig. You know, is there a better one to choose between those? And, you know, not really. Honestly, to get really down to that, we'd have to do some investigative journalism and really see, like, exactly where are they getting the sources from, all the way down to when it gets onto the shelf. I would personally probably steer more away from fish just because of a lot of fish farming going on and fungal issues in the fish population. And for me, it just doesn't really feel ethical. And when fish are being sold, they're usually being sold with the skin on. So then I start to worry, you know, are they doing farming fishing just to use the skin to get the collagen out of it? Like, to me, doing like a larger animal where the hide might get thrown away anyway would be preferable, because then at least we're using that whole animal and that hide again is being boiled down, and that's what's creating the collagen peptides. I'm going to share a couple companies that use grass-fed, pasture-raised cow hides for their product, which seems to me what I would personally choose. So then somebody also asked, how do you find quality collagen products? So it's really about trusting the company and then using some of these third-party testing sites to make sure that this company is staying up to the standards that they're saying that they are. So I have the three names that I want to give you. The first one, Vericel, is that collagen peptide that has a lot of great research on it. And there's collagen, Dynamic Collagen Renew is a product that we like to use at our clinic, and I'm going to link it below. So that one has a blend of different types of collagen, so it's good for skin and for joints. And then there's two other companies that I really respect when it comes to collagen, and these are the ones that are getting it from a grass-fed pastured cows, so bovine, and it's Great Lakes and Vital Proteins, and I'll link those down below as well. I know there's a lot of concern about environmental issues with meat, but just know if a farm is raising and rotating and is set up in the right way, it can actually help to sequester carbon from the atmosphere. And a part of that whole farm setup, they need animals in order to make it function properly. So certainly a lot of people are buying meat from factory farming and we are eating way too much from that side of it. But just know if you're supporting some of these farms that are like polyface farms, you can look that up if you want to learn more, they can actually help with environmental concerns. All right, and last but not least, this is probably my favorite part of the whole video, is how do you get it from food? Because nobody's even talking about that, right? You can get collagen from food, like really, really pretty easily. And it's just in the skin of animals, right? So if you're eating a chicken, instead of buying just chicken breast because you maybe think it's healthier white meat, that's a topic for a whole nother video. But buy the whole chicken. Buy from a good source. Buy chickens that are running around out on the grass from a local farmer, and put that in your slow cooker or even your pressure cooker. I cooked a whole kitchen, whole kitchen, whole chicken, which apparently chicken and kitchen are two words that are really hard and easy to get confused when learning the English language, but I digress. So apparently I cooked a whole chicken in a pressure cooker once and it turned out really, really good. And it was like frozen to done in 30 minutes, just like blew my mind. But anyway, do that and then eat the skin because that's where you're gonna get the collagen. Or, you know, if you know somebody who knows how to prepare, if you are up for preparing chicken feet, they have a really high amount of collagen in them as well. So you could throw a chicken foot or make broth out of chicken feet and then use that in your soups and things. So just two chicken feet have about 10 grams of collagen. And that's like the high end of the recommendation. You might just need about 2.5 grams a day to get these benefits. And fish, when you're eating fish, eat it with the skin on. Eat that skin and get the collagen from the skin. So it's just kind of changing our mind around about whole animal eating and you're gonna get what you need. So I hope this is helpful. Let me know in the comments below. And if you are struggling with gut issues and you have concerns about absorption proteins and other foods, just reach out to our clinic. We do offer a free call to make sure it's a good fit and explain if your insurance might be able to cover, if not, what our other options are, and I'll link that below as well. So thank you, everybody. I hope you have a great day, and let me know if you have ideas for future videos because this idea totally came from you guys asking about it. And don't forget, subscribe. And then hit the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of our new videos every Tuesday at 3 p.m. Central Time. Thank you all. Thanks for your support, and I'll see you next week.